Hi students, today we will discuss new concept, that is an product method. In the last class already we have discussed profit and loss appropriation account, how to distribute the profits of all the partners. So let's see, now we will discuss about the product method. So before going the problems, first what is product method? Let me know the meaning. The first product method, under this method, for each withdrawal, the money, that is amount. Money means nothing but amount. So here withdrawal is multiplied by the period. The money is, the amount is multiplied by the periods. So usually expressed in number of months. Whatever the amounts we are multiplying with the months may be usually expressed in the number of months for which it is remained, withdrawn during the financial year, at the end of the assessment year to beginning of the year. Whatever the amounts we have withdrawn in the business, for that amount we need to calculate the total interest. The period is calculated. The period is calculated from the date of the withdrawals. From the date of the withdrawals to the last date of the accounting period. The last date of the accounting period or accounting year. So here the products so calculated are totaled out of the total of the products. Total out of the whatever the amounts. Amounts into total number of outstanding credit we need to multiply, that is an product. So here let me know once again, under this method, for each withdrawal the money or amount is multiplied by the period. So here period means nothing but number of outstanding credit for which is remained, withdrawn during the financial year. The period is calculated from the date of withdrawals to the last date of the financial year. So here the products so calculated are totaled and out of the total of the products. So here the total and interested for 1 month. So here whatever the amounts we are calculated, that amount we need to take multiply with the specified rate is worked out of the total product. So here there is a formula for the calculation of interest. The formula, total product into rate into 1/12. So here there is a formula for the calculation of interest, total product into rate into 1/12. This is what formula for the calculation of interest on drawings. So here let me know when we will discuss one question in this method. So here the question, this is what based on the question bank as per the PU board provided. So here in that question, as per the page number 25 and question number 1. So here the question, problems are calculated of interest on drawings. So under this method, now we need to calculate one question. So here let me go, let me start the question. So here, Yashasvi and Tapasvi are partners in a firm. So here, there are two partners in a business. The partners are namely Yashasvi and Tapasvi are partners in a firm. During the year ended, on 31st March 2016. So this is what end of the assessment year. 31st March 2016, this is what end of the assessment year. So for here, Yashasvi makes a drawing. So here, there are two partners in a business, but in this business organization, only one partner is making the drawings. So these drawings are as under. So here the date of drawings as well as amounts are available. So let me know, first we need to take format for the calculation of interest on drawings. For that, then calculation of interest on drawings of which partner has with the drawing means making drawing means Yashasvi. For the calculation of interest and drawings, we need to take 4 columns. So here, the first column regarding date of drawings, second column regarding amount of drawings, third column number of outstanding period or months. Number of outstanding period or months. Last column for that chord. This is what format for the calculation of interest on drawings of HSV. So here, the first date of price, let them be need to finish the first date. In the beginning, they are withdrawing on 1-8-2015. In this date, how much amount they are withdrawing means? So here, 5000 rupees. You have to record in that amount column. On the same thing, the next particular date, 31st December 2015. In this date particular, they are withdrawn rupees 10,000. This is what second amount of drawings withdrawals by the partners. The next one, 31st March 2016, this is what end of the assessment year. Actually, in this question, the assessment year is as on 1-4-2015 to 31st March 2016. This is what assessment year. In this assessment year, end of the day, they have withdrawn rupees 15,000. This is what available information for the calculation of interest on drawings. So under that, they given some required information for the calculation of interest on drawings. Partnership deed provides that partners are to be charged interest on drawings at 12% per annum. So here, we need to calculate interest on drawings. So before the calculation of interest on drawings, first of all, we need to identify the total products in the business organization. So for here, first we need to identify the in the beginning, whatever the amounts withdrawn by the partners, first we need to identify the outstanding number of months or period. So this is what ascertaining by the way from the date of withdrawal to from the date of end of the assessment year, from the date of last balance sheet to till the date of withdrawal, we need to identify. So for here, so here as on 1-8-2050, in this particular date they are withdrawing rupees 5000, but books of accounts are closing on 31st March 2016, right? So here as on, first of all, the assessment year 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3. This is what total number of months in a year. So this is what total number of months in a year. This is what assessment from April to 31st March. So in that beginning, so by the way, offering these calculation, easily we can ascertain the outstanding period. So when they are actually withdrawing 1/8 means in this month they are withdrawing. So now we have to count. So here 8. So from here to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here this is what outstanding period. The outstanding period for that first one 8 months. This is what first thing. And the same being in the second particular date, they are withdrawing 31st December. I mean 31st December in this date, end of the month they are withdrawing. So in this particular date, no need to take this month because of at the end of the month, they are withdrawing means we need to take from the next month onward. The next month onward means January, February and March. There are 3 months are outstanding period. And the next particular date, so again they are withdrawing. So how much amount they are withdrawing? 15,000. When they are withdrawing? As on 31st March 2016, in this date they are withdrawing 15,000. But here we are not able to record outstanding period because of at the end of the month only they are withdrawn. So here no need to charge the rate of interest in that particular during the year. So just we need to take a zero because of at the end of the year only they are withdrawing. That's what we no need to take number of outstanding period because of this is what end of the assessment year. So here now we need to multiply. So here we need to ascertain product. By the way, ascertaining this product, we need to multiply with the amount and outstanding period. So here 5000 into number of months are 8000. I mean 8. So 5 8s are 40. I mean we get 40,000. This is my total product. And the same being in the next particular date, the amount of drawings are 10,000, outstanding period 3. 10,000 into 3 means we will get 30,000. So here 5,000 into 8 means we will get 40,000. And the same being 10,000 into 3 means 30,000. The next thing 15,000 into 0 means we will get 0 only. So just have to record name. No need to write the values because of at the end of the month they are withdrawing, right? That's why no need to record the outstanding period. So this is what calculation. Now we need to ascertain the total product. So here total product. Total product is 70,000. So now we are completed even by the way ascertaining the product. But as per the question, what we need to calculate? We need to calculate interest on drawings. For the calculation of interest on drawings, there is an formula. Now we need to apply that formula. The formula interest on drawings equals to total product into rate. As per the given question, the specified rate already they given. The specified rate is 12%. I mean 12 divided by 100. So here the formula interest on drawings equals to total product into rate into 1 by 12. This is what formula. Now we can apply the values. These available values, these are the values already we are ascertaining. So here interest on drawings equals to total product. Total product already we are calculated by the way applying the format. The total product is 70,000 into the rate of interest already given in the question. The rate of interest 12%. 12/100 into 1/12. This is what constant. The total outstanding debt. We can take 1 month for the calculation of interest and drawings. 1/12. So now we have to multiply 70,000 into 12% into 1/12. So now we have to calculate once again. So here you will get 700. So here that's 7,000. This is what total interest on SSV's drawings will be rupees 700. This is what calculation of interest on drawings. So here finally we need to write. Interest on drawings of HSPs will be rupees 700. This is what calculation of interest on drawings. Let me know once again we will discuss in this question. So here this is what particular date. Whenever they are withdrawing the amounts on that particular date, we are recording. And on that particular date, how much amount they are withdrawing, the amounts we are recording. The next one, outstanding period, we are calculated from the date of withdrawal to end of the assessment year period. So this is what we are ascertaining from the date of withdrawal to end of the assessment year. And finally, we are multiplied with the amounts as well as number of outstanding. So by the way, multiplying, we will get total product. So by the way of preparing this format, we are ascertaining total product. But we need to find out interest and drawings. For that interest and drawings, there is a formula. Interest and drawings equals to total product into rate into 1/12. This is what formula for the calculation of interest on drawings. So here, the total product already we are ascertaining 70,000 into 12. What is it 12? That 12% is the rate of interest. This is what already they are given in the question. The annual rate of interest they are charging 12%. 12/100 into 1/12. 1/12, this is what constant we are charging interest. When we are multiplying with the amounts and much means other thing we can take 1/12, 1 month we can take as the draw interest and drawing. So by the way, multiplying these values, you will get 700 rupees. So here this is what 700 interest on drawings of HSP's drawings will be rupees 700. So this is what calculation of interest on drawings of each partners. So in this question we are ascertained, we are learned how to calculate interest on drawings. So on the same way we will calculate in the some other particular days, whether it may be beginning of the assessment year, end of the assessment year, middle of the year, or quarterly basis, or end of the each quarterly, beginning of the each quarterly, and different interval periods we can calculate it on the same manner. So in this session we are calculated in this by the way product method. By the way, obtaining this product method, we are ascertaining interest on drawings. So let me, we will discuss in the next session on the same method of couple of questions we can discuss in the next class. Okay, thank you.